So we have a special guest here today, Brandon Bam Bam Rios. So Brandon, first of all the fans want to know, how are you doing? How's everything?
Well, you know, I've been good, you know, just been in the gym, just staying physically in shape. I haven't really lost my condition as much since the Bradley fight. But other than that, I've just been good, just staying home, been in the gym, man, that's all.
Speaking of Bradley, April 9th, him and Manny Pacquiao, you faced Pacquiao, you faced Bradley. What do you think of the fight?
It's going to be a good fight, you know, maybe hopefully it's a good fight. Hopefully, you know, the third one, we'll see. And so, you know, we'll see what's going to happen.
What do you think about Amir Khan Canelo?
Amir Khan, he's going to get caught. That's the only thing that's a problem with Amir Khan. He has the goods. Yes, he can move. He got speed. But the only thing he don't have is that chin. And Canelo can punch. And it's going to be he's facing a big puncher.
Now, if Brandon Rios could line up three opponents, who would you want? If you could pick any three people on the planet.
Me, myself, and I.
You would fight yourself, and who would win?
Yeah. Myself. Nah, you know, nothing. I don't really have nothing in mind like that. If three opponents in line, I'd love to go after Triple G. I'd love to face him, just get knocked the fuck out. Let me see who else. Kovalev. I'd love to get knocked the fuck out with that guy. And Julio Cesar Chavez, senior. If he was still fighting back in the prime days, yes, him.
But all those guys are much bigger weight classes except Chavez Sr. Weight class,
but
when you come back, Brandon, when you come back in the ring, is it 54, is it 47, is it 40?
Well, 47. If I come back, it'll be 47 or maybe, yeah, 47. I feel comfortable at 147. 54 is too big. Like I said, if I come back, I'm not really eyeing nobody. I just want to get back to the top. I know I got to work my way back up again if I do. But, you know, we'll see, you know. Life's too short.
No, of course. And the thing is, you're training now every day. You look like you're getting in shape.
Yeah, like I said, I've been staying in physically in shape. I haven't blow up like I usually get when I blow up. Like for the Bradley fight, it was my I was training just to lose the weight. I wasn't really training for the fight. So, you know, that was my fault right there. I came in camp really heavy. I had nobody to blame for, but, you know, at the end of the day, fuck it, it is what it is.
Now, Brent, I got to ask you this. Manny Pacquiao has super fast hands. Tim Bradley has super fast hands. Being in the ring with both of them, who do you think is faster?
Pacquiao.
Why?
Pacquiao has fast hands. That guy is, there's like a crime scene going on right now.
Where? In the ring or in the...
Oh, shit, they're holding up on a gunpoint.
No way. Show us.
Huh?
Show us on camera.
But I passed.
Oh, okay.
They called the tour and everybody go around.
Well, welcome to Oxnard.
Welcome to Oxnard. Welcome to the TK, Little Chicago.
Little Chicago. What did the guy do that they pull a gun on him?
I don't know. We're going to find out. We'll find out in the news later. It was crazy.
It happened already once in Oxnard where they shot someone and he didn't do anything. He didn't even have a gun. You remember some kid?
Yeah. That happened in Oxnard. It was, I forgot when it was, but... Yes, it did happen. But there's like guns right now. It's like a guy, he's like having hands up in the air like, I'm innocent, don't shoot.
So there's election this year in the United States. If Brandon Rios was running for president of the United States, what would be your most important issues?
My most important issues? I wouldn't know because I'm not a fucking politics guy, so I really wouldn't give a fuck. Long as my important issue would be
lower the taxes, that's for me.
Yeah, well, the cops right here, wait, they make me go this way.
Okay.
Well, they arrest a lady and, they arrest all kinds of people.
Was it a sweep today?
No, I don't know. I don't know if it's sweep, but dude, they got the thing blocked, the road blocked like crazy. Welcome to Oxnard, homie. This is a chicken. Welcome to the chicken. Caco.
No, I think lowering taxes is important. That's to me. I don't know about it.
Lowering taxes for the one that, you know, that do good, because right now it was like 40% to certain brackets. It's crazy, man. It's you working for nothing. I say lower taxes. I might be bad for saying this, but take people off welfare and all that shit, because that ruins everything.
And you grew up on welfare.
I never grew up on welfare.
No, in Kansas.
We never grew up on welfare.
You didn't?
Nope, my dad was working his ass off. We was poor, whatever we had, we got. Like, certain some days, I never, some days we'll go out eating, but I never grew up on fucking welfare.
Oh, okay.
My parents never believed in that.
Wow, but both of them, did your mom ever work?
My mom was working until the company not fired, but until the company got the new ownership, they closed down the company, and then she stopped working, and you know, it was really rough on money. So, I never grew up on welfare or nothing. I was just poor, but never grew up on welfare.
But that kind of sucks to have both parents working and still not having money.
No, when we had both parents working, we was making it, you know, we was living a good life. We was living a rich life. We was living all right. You know, we had food on table and everything. We had stuff, but when one parent got, like, the company got shut down, the other parent was only working, it was just horrible.
That sucks. But here's the thing, Brandon. So right now, you're training. You don't know when you'll fight. It should be coming up if it comes up. Will your dad work your corner?
Yes, he is. I already talked to my pops. He said he's more than happy and willing to work the corner. But like I said, at the end of the day, it's if I do come back. You know what I mean? Like, I know I'm just staying in shape because my wife's on me. She's telling me, you know, you got to keep in shape. Just because if you don't fight no more, don't get big. You know, you got to stay healthy. So, you know, I've just been in the gym and everything, just been working physically. No boxing yet. I haven't really hit the bags, nothing like that, which I do miss hitting the bags. But we'll find out and see.
Okay, I'm going to ask you about this fight. They just announced it. John Molina Jr., who you sparred,
and
against Ruslan Provodnikov, who you always wanted to fight. What do you think of that one?
It should be a good fight. I think John Molina, if he can land that straight right hand or that hook, whatever he has, he can probably knock him out. But we'll see how it goes. Ruslan loves the brawl. We'll see if Molina can withstand his pressure. So it's going to be a good fight. We'll check it out. Hopefully it's a good fight.
Okay, Adrian Broner, Ashley Theophane.
I heard that they had some beef in sparring. I heard that Ashley, whatever his name is, he fucked up Adrian Broner in sparring. That's the word, but we don't know. We're going to check it out. It's going to be pretty cool.
It's going to be fun. It's TMT against About Billions.
Yeah, but you know, years like, man, fuck TMT. I was like, what? Broner's crazy.
He's crazy.
You know, it should be a good fight. Hopefully it's a good fight too.
Man, he's also cool. He's cool.
Yeah, you know, I never really, like, I got to see the guy here and there, you know, talk to him. He's cool people.
By the way, speaking of this, Chino Maidana said that he's thinking of coming back.
Yeah, man, well, I wonder what way he's going to come back to, but hopefully he does, man. Chino Maidana, he's still young. He still has a lot in him, but we'll see what happens, man. The guy retirement, he was making fun of his weight. Hey, fuck, let the guy be. He done everything right. He done everything he had to do in the ring.
He never bothered anybody. He never did anybody wrong.
No, nope. Right. And he never talks shit about anybody. If he comes back, he comes back. If he don't, fuck, let the guy be. Let him eat his life. Let him do what he got to do. You know what I mean?
That's why, Brandon, I didn't post any of his pictures because I didn't want people like just to, you know, clown on him for no reason. He's a good dude. So, you know, he's enjoying life.
I seen that picture that he posted. I was like, so what, man? The guy's retired, man. He's cool, man. He did everything he had to do. He fought his heart out for us, and fuck it.
So, Mauricio Herrera, Frankie Gomez, who do you like?
I'll go on Mauricio Herrera because Frankie Gomez haven't been active. And so I think that's why Mauricio has a big advantage in that fight, because Frankie Gomez hasn't really been active. And his last fight, he didn't look really impressive.
What do fans tell you these days? Like, when you hear it from fans, Twitter, Instagram, and your website?
Nah, like, don't retire, Bam Bam. We need boxing, needs you. You put on an exciting show. Don't retire. You never know, you know?
You know what a lot of fans were saying online? That Nate Diaz and Nick Diaz, because after he beat Conor McGregor, he said they said that he's like they are the Brandon Rios of MMA.
You see how he talks shit? That guy is fucking badass. I actually watched that fight. People up here in Agoura Hills, at the gym where I go train, they was telling me man, you should get this fight. It's a good fight.